the best heavyweight prospects in the game, undefeated Hasim Rahman Jr. Rock, we're in Philly tonight. I was hearing that you might have a fight coming up soon. What's the date? What's going on?
I was supposed to fight tonight here on Devin Haney's undercard, but my opponent pulled out, unfortunately. But right now, we got scheduled June 29th, Baltimore, Maryland, Martins West, myself, my brother Sharif, my uncle Mustard Kaysen, we got Malik Hawkins, Tarisha Douglas, and standout amateur Lorenzo Simpson opening the show. So if you're in Baltimore, come out to Martins West, have a good time. June 29th, we're coming to show up.
Now, I'm really sorry to hear that your fight was canceled, because a card with you and Devin Haney on a show, I mean, that's a great card
that
we missed out on.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we was all pumped up for the fight, but Vitaly Klitschko ducked my dad all the way up, you know, that's all the way at the top level of the sport. So it's going to happen. You know, it's something that I have to learn about in the sport, and it's something that I'm going to get through. So I'm just looking forward to more fights.
What's going on, though? This guy pulled out. You had a guy who went in the ring and then went, didn't want to fight. He showed up on fight night and then didn't fight you.
Yeah.
So it's a lot of, how are you reacting to all this?
I mean, a lot of people let it get to their head. For me, I see it as I wasn't ready. So God protected me. So I don't take it as, you know, people are scared of me or people are ducking me or nothing like that. I just take it as I wasn't prepared for that moment. So in order for me to keep walking the way that I need to walk, in order to get to the pinnacle, then that's what needed to happen. So, I just take it in stride. I still got to fight again and again and again after that. So I just take it in stride and don't let that get to me.
It wasn't meant to be.
Excuse me?
It wasn't meant to be.
It wasn't meant to be.
So at 4-0 now, I got those heading to your fifth pro fight. How are you feeling skill-wise? How are you feeling as a professional fighter right now?
I feel like before I turned pro, I didn't know as much as I know now. Now knowing what it takes to be at the top of echelon of the sport, it's a real big eye-opener. And I know I still got a long road ahead of me. So I got a lot more work to put in. And good thing about me, I got a lot of boxing in my background. So I know the work that it takes, and I know what it takes to become the man at the top of the division.
Do you size up them top guys as future, you know, guys you're hunting after, Joshua and Wilder?
That's the only two. Only if you got a belt. Anybody else is just in the way. So, you know, if you got a belt, yeah, I'm sizing you up, absolutely. So right now, the heavyweight names to me are Deontay Wilder and Anthony Joshua. So, you know, eventually it's going to only be one. So, I'm not sizing nobody up but them, though. That's it. They're the only two people that I'm thinking about every day when I'm training.
What happens when you get your opportunity to fight for the title if it's against one of them? What goes down?
We make history. We've done it before. We're going to do it again.
Now, I want to ask you real quick, man. I've never asked you Wilder Joshua. What's your breakdown on that fight? Who would win that fight?
Me?
No, between the two.
Now, I like Wilder. I think Wilder has just going from between the back and forth and what's all going on. It's just their interaction between the way they talk about each other. I just think Wilder has the edge. I think that he would be the victor if they fought.
So it's more of a mental thing, you're saying? Like you say Wilder is like more mentally strong?
Just think he's already won the fight. Fights are won or lost in the outside the ring, long before you meet in that square circle. So right now, in this moment, Deontay Wilder has a huge advantage, in my opinion. I don't think Anthony Joshua should take that fight if it was him. I don't think he wins that fight at all. I don't see a scenario where he wins. What is he gonna do? Is he gonna outpoint Deontay? No. Is he gonna knock Deontay out with one punch?
You don't think Joshua can knock him out?
I don't think he can knock him out even with one punch. Joshua has not exhibited one punch knockout power. Deontay's vulnerability comes from one punch knockout power. Joshua doesn't show that, so I think that Wilder holds the edge in the fight. But it's boxing. Of course Joshua can win. Of course Joshua can knock him out. That's what I'm planning to do. I'm planning to upset somebody. But I think that the favorite in that fight would be Wilder.
Finishing up, man, I gotta ask, because you said you saw it in conversation, like sizing up, how they interact with each other. Like, what exactly was it that you're like, it's Wilder?
I was probably on FightHype.com watching the interview, and I seen their mannerisms and the way they talk and the way they talk about one another. I believe that Deontay is ready for the fight, and I believe that Anthony to get in there and put everything on the line that he's worked for. But Deontay wants to do it immediately. So that shows you who wants to fight a little bit more.
Anything else you want to let the fans know, man, before?
Let the fans know that being undefeated is overrated. There's a lot of guys out here with losses that aren't undefeated and they slept on. And, you know, being undefeated is great. But in this era of boxing, being undefeated is overrated. So don't sleep on these guys. I'm undefeated, but like I said, it's overrated to be undefeated. I want to remain undefeated. I want to retire undefeated. But the greats of the sport, the greats of the sport, were not undefeated.
Right.
When you look back until this era, the past few years, being undefeated didn't mean as much as it means now. But, you know, I mean, to each his own. I'm a boxing fan. I'm a pure boxing fan. There's a lot of great fighters out there that got losses on their record that's not getting recognition. And I just wanted to let the boxing fans know, even though I'm undefeated, we're going to stay undefeated. Being undefeated is underrated. It's a lot of guys out there with losses that deserve the opportunity to shine.
Hey, thanks, Rock.
No doubt.